Hi guys, today we are going to start a smoking hot topic discussion, and that is Bootstrap. Well, Bootstrap was created by a designer and a developer at Twitter. It has become one of the most popular front-end framework and open source projects in the world. Bootstrap is most popular HTML, CSS, JavaScript framework for developing responsive mobile-first projects on the web. Where HTML gives structure, CSS gives styling, and JavaScript gives the behavior. Bootstrap was created at Twitter in mid-2010 by Mark Otto and Jacob. Prior to being an open source framework, Bootstrap was known as Twitter Blueprint. A few months into development, and Twitter had its first hack week. And the project exploded as developers from all skill levels jumped in without any external guidance. It served as a style guide for internal tools development at the company for over like 1 year before its public release, and it continues to do so even today. Bootstrap was released on Friday, August 19th, 2011. It since had over 20 releases, including two major rewrites with version 2 and version 3. In Bootstrap 2, the responsive functionality was added to the entire framework as an optional style sheet. Building on with that, Bootstrap 3, it rewrote the whole library once more to make it responsive by default with a mobile-first approach. The core team of Bootstrap. Bootstrap is maintained by its founding team and a small group of invaluable core contributors with massive support and involvement from the community. Some of the team members include Mark Otto, Jacob Fronten, Chris Roberts, Julian Phalo, and many more. Bootstrap's official website is getbootstrap.com. You can download and find the documentation in this site. Now, what Bootstrap does? That is the question. Bootstrap easily and efficiently scales your website and applications with a single code base, from phones to tablets to desktops, with CSS media queries. With Bootstrap, you get extensive and beautiful documentation for common HTML elements, dozens of custom HTML and CSS components, and awesome jQuery plugins. In the next tutorial, we will discuss about how to create the first Bootstrap example. For the next tutorial, please subscribe to Codes Wizard and let us know if there is any comment from your side. Thank you!